Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. Today, our discussion is on internal energy. In this video, you will learn about how internal energy is defined and some important concepts about internal energy. Scientists believe that the smallest unit of matter is atom. An atom consists of a nucleus surrounded by electrons. Some atoms can exist alone, for example, helium and argon. Others may join with other atoms to form molecules. For example, water and carbon dioxide are molecules. In physics, atoms and molecules are collectively called particles. Now note that these three terms, atoms, molecules, and particles, are often used interchangeably to mean those invisible units of matter. Although we cannot view atoms directly, many experiments have proved that about absolute zero, atoms are moving all the time. For example, in a solid, molecules are vibrating about their fixed position. In a liquid, molecules can move around each other. In a gas, the molecules are moving at high speed in random direction. On the other hand, when an object changes its state of matter from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas, energy is required to separate the molecules. The energy supplied to the molecule is called potential energy. From the above discussion, we can conclude that molecules have both kinetic energy and potential energy. Now, we define internal energy. Internal energy of an object is defined as the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy of its molecules. What does internal energy depend on? A hot object has more internal energy than a cold one because its molecules are moving faster. For an object, its liquid form has more internal energy than its solid form because the molecules in the liquid have more potential energy. Therefore, to increase the internal energy of an object, we can do two things. One, increase the temperature of the object. Two, change the state of matter from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas. Important concepts. One important concept is that the internal energy cannot be measured directly. Also, we never know the exact value of the internal energy of an object. Another important concept about internal energy is heat flow. Heat may not flow from an object with more internal energy. Now, this is because heat always flows from a hot object to a cold one. In this video, you have learned that internal energy of an object is the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy of its molecules. Also, internal energy depends on 1. The amount of molecules, 2. Temperature, and 3. State of matter. Finally, it is important to note that for an object at rest, it does not have kinetic energy. However, all its molecules do have internal energy. It means that all objects have internal energy. Thank you for watching.